The next game is Montreal, Florida, 55-56. We've got Florida minus 120, a home favorite, total 5.5, shaded to the under. I know Dana Lane had a play recently at some point earlier this week on the Florida Panthers on home ice, and they got the job done that night. It was against Philadelphia, that's right, earlier in the week, and they took care of business, won that hockey game, so kudos to Dana for that. Is he going back to the well with Florida tonight is the question, or is he going to look at the total? Because he does have a play, does have a stance on this Hab-Panther matchup tonight. Dana, what are you looking at here down in South Florida?
Well, first, before we get to that, I must have missed it. Andrew, I knew the other day that you had the pom-poms out for Team Canada against you against the USA. What happened in that game? Because it appeared that you were very confident in the outcome of that game. I don't know. I mean, Canada, obviously, it's the birthplace of hockey, so certainly you won that game. Is that accurate?
You got to be honest now, Andrew.
Winning a group stage game doesn't... Well, I mean, to my understanding, a group stage win doesn't mean you won the tournament. So we can check back after the finals.
No, that's exactly right. I was just going off of what happened last year as well. So I just assumed that you would get the revenge spot. But that's okay. That's okay. I think they won last year, too. Anyway, yeah, Florida, to Montreal
in.
Tonight.
You had to get that in. It's okay.
Yes, you did. Of course.
Can Believe I just me,
it's
tell
no...
you?
It's no skin off my back that Canada wins or loses this tournament, by the way. I got to point that out. My life is not going to be made any one damn bit better by Canada winning a flipping gold medal at the World Juniors. Do I want to see it? Sure. But am I going to just crawl into the fetal position, suck on my thumb, and say life is over if they lose the gold medal? That's not going to happen. Sorry. I'm not one of these religious and just put my hand on the Bible, swear on it for the World Junior Hockey Championship every year like so many Canadians are. Sorry, I like to see them win, do well, don't get me wrong, but believe me, I'm not going to be in any sort of depression state for the rest of my life if they don't win. Go ahead, Dana.
I'll say this.
I'll make you a deal,
about...
Dana.
Here we go. Okay, yeah.
No. If USA beats Canada and finishes in a better place than Canada, I'll wear a USA basketball jersey on our show after the World Juniors finishes.
No, Andrew. I know that that's not a big deal to you because I would wear a Team Canada jersey because I support our friends up there. What I do want of you is, and if you don't have one, I'll send one to you. I would like you to wear a Boston Bruins jersey.
Oh, yes. That's cutting to the core for someone that's a devoted Habs fan like Andrew. Yeah.
I'm confident in the Canadians. I will say this, and I appreciate the outdoor version of this game, and I get it and everything, but it's like, you know, these two teams, you know, play in these elements where anything could possibly happen, and I just like everybody to kind of play on the same level, you know, playing indoors like everybody else. I don't know. Anyway, USA get the win, so whatever. Yeah, Florida-Montreal tonight. I mean, I think it's fair to say that the Panthers are probably playing their best hockey this year. They're on a four-game winning streak, and of course, we know that Montreal is just so up and down. I mean, it's just – now, I really want to be confident because every time I see Carey Price in net, I always think, man, we got a shot to win this. Even, you know, now it's not that big of a deal to see Carey Price at a plus price. I just get to the point where – I just can't do it anymore. And there's something, I don't know whether or not it's culture. I don't know if it's pressure. I don't know if it's just a bunch of guys there just aren't happy, because sometimes I watch them play and I just go, I don't think this team's happy. I don't think Claude Julien's happy. I think if he had to do it all over again, he'd probably days and if that was an option. But Florida Panthers are the 500 team for the first time since October 4th or 14th, and you know, and that of course is the NHL's version of 500, and we got a little time today, so I just wanted to bring this up, and maybe I did the other day, but guys, when you're looking at records and you think, wow, this Carolina is a perfect example, take those shootout losses and the overtime losses and add them to the loss column, because that's exactly what a team actually is. But it's the same thing here with Florida. I mean, yes, 500, NHL 500 for sure, but you know, take those extra time games and add them to the loss column if that applies. For the Panthers, their top line has been playing fantastic. They're getting contributions from their second line. Huberdeau, Barkov, and Bukestad are absolutely on fire. Dadonov and Trocheck and Malgin definitely gives the Panthers a potent top six. So I have noticed this, guys, when I look up and down rosters and I kind of look at current form of how a team is playing, I have noticed this. There's a lot of teams, and I don't mean to toot the Vegas Golden Knights horn at all, but, and we've said this a million times, but man, I'm telling you, there's a lot of teams that are struggling to find two lines, but let alone getting any contribution from their third and fourth line. And that's why when we talk about depth so much, I mean, that when you could roll four lines out there that legitimately could put the puck in a net, I mean, that is such an advantage over a team that really struggles to find a top six forward group to contribute. But for the Panthers, or for the Montreal Canadiens, that's definitely something that we can't say right now. I can't say that their top six are giving me any confidence to put my money behind. They've dropped three straight games, so I'm definitely going to ride the Florida Panthers and a team. Maybe, I don't know, maybe analytics is finally working down in Florida, but they seem to be moving forward, and I don't see any reason to not jump on the home team tonight.
Yeah, Montreal's had a real tough time scoring goals. I mean, one goal in each of their last three games, all of them losses. They've only cracked more than three goals, when you look at it, one time in their last 10 games, and that was against Vancouver, who have been horrendous defensively lately. We've talked about this repeatedly on this show, that Vancouver's defense has evaporated in recent weeks, and their goaltending's not been the same either. That's Montreal's one shining moment of cracking more than three goals in a single game in the last 10. So that tells you what you need to know about this team's troubles offensively. I am sick to death, and I know Andrew is too, because he's mentioned this guy before, of Plekanec. This guy's driving you bonkers if you're a Hab fan right now. Like, what kind of purpose does he serve on the ice rather than take up space and pick his nose on the ice? I really don't know at this point. And wear a cheap-looking turtleneck to make himself look like a dope. I mean, really, what other purpose are you serving? Not much else right now for this Montreal team. So, but there's other issues, I know, but that guy for years has just been, you know, you expect something out of this guy. Actually, when he joined Montreal, he was actually not a bad player, but where's that gone? He's not been any sort of this reliable force for the Montreal Canadiens in recent years. So Dana's going right back to the well. Hey, if you're going to back Florida, now's the time to do it, because they're feeling good. They've got some confidence. They've won four straight. You know, nice win the other night. James Reimer's playing good. I mean, ride James Reimer while he's playing. He is one of those streaky goalies. You want to be on him when he's in a zone. You want to be totally right off against him as soon as you see things go south. They will at some point again for Reimer. We've seen enough of him going back to Toronto. They'll find a way to go south again and struggle and let goals in that he shouldn't. Right now, he's seeing the puck well. The quotes speak to that. You know, some of the comments recently from Reimer are that he's feeling better, more comfortable. He's got more games under his belt. Still think he's going to hit a rough patch again at some point, because that's usually what he does. But while he is playing well, which he is right now, you just go with it for now until you see signs of him going back in the other direction. And right now, his playing between the pipes, big part of the reason too. Why the Florida Panthers have done very, very well. I think Andrew wants to say something here. He's leaning over. Go ahead, buddy.
I need to say this about the Drouin and Sergachev trade. I just have to say that, you know, we're always bashing on Plekanec and all these other guys, but the fact is, people like Pacioretty and now Drouin have to perform. I mean, let's face it, guys. I keep saying this about the Canadians, but I think it's more true than any other team. I mean, let's take the Pittsburgh Penguins, for example. Think about the Penguins right now. You can give me Crosby. You can give me Kessel. You can give me Malkin. You can give me Letang. You can even give me Jake Guentzel. You know, all these guys that are just guys you can count on and stuff like that. Depth players. For me, who would you guys really even say? I mean, I know we've got some more time today on our show. Who are the real all-stars for this Canadiens team? Because it's not Max Pacioretty. It's not Jonathan Drouin. Start of the season, it wasn't even Carey Price. You know, right now I'm starting to think that even if you start scoring a little bit more, Brendan Gallagher might be one of the best players on this team. Paul Byron, might as well give him the C, because he's doing a hell of a lot more than Max Pacioretty's doing. You know, it just doesn't make any sense to me. Sergachev has more goals, more assists, and a far, far, far better plus minus. I know he's playing on a far better team, but the fact that, first of all, it starts with ownership, and then it goes to management, and then it's coaching as well. I think Marc Bergevin, for some reason, wanted Drouin to be a center right when he arrived because they desperately needed one. They needed a first-line center. So it's like, hey, let's pick up a guy that played tremendous as a winger in junior. I watched him his whole career in junior at the Mooseheads. That's where he thrived. That's where he plays best. Then when he was in Tampa, they tried him out there every now and then. But then they put him back on the wing again, and he starts scoring goals. Then he goes down to the AHL for a couple games, plays a little bit of center, plays a little bit of wing, and all of a sudden he looks comfortable. I'm telling you guys, he is way too small to be in the center. He's not used to it, didn't really grow up playing at a high level at that position. And he's one of those crafty players that needs more space. He needs to be on the wing, guys, to kind of just dangle around people and do his thing. He's one of those players that you got to give him some space. You got to give him some time. Put somebody else in the middle. Put Galchenyuk in the middle on his line and let him pass it out to Drouin, because this isn't working out whatsoever, guys. And, I'm not even considering this really a Montreal rant. I think this is just facts about the NHL right now that was supposed to be the big move. I mean, the two last big moves the Montreal Canadiens have made, guys, are trading away what was supposed to be their franchise defenseman in PK Subban for a guy that's around 4 or 5 years older than him, and then trading away their number one prospect in Mikhail Sergachev, just only to get Drouin, who's kind of not even really made a name for himself yet in the NHL. And then he gets here and they force him to play center on a struggling team with Claude Julien, who comes in to a team that can't even score goals. And like Ian points out all the time, he's a defensive-minded coach. So you might as well bring in a defensive-minded coach. But as long as he speaks French, that's fine, guys. We'll bring in a defensive-minded coach to be with the Montreal media to teach them how to score goals. So it just doesn't make any sense to me. I hope that they tank. I hope that they throw everything away. Anything that they've got to offer, I hope they just throw it all away. Throw it right in the dumpster at the trade deadline. Because that's what they need to do, guys. I mean, because it's going to be the same thing as it was last year. They're going to be in the middle of the pack. They're not going to finish like last couple of teams. But they're going to finish just enough just to get the exact same spot in the draft that they were last year. Because they never get any high picks. They're always just somewhere in the middle of the draft. So they need to start somewhere. I mean, at least try and get me a high prospect. Because the fact that they lost Sergachev, I mean, I can be biased and say I like Drouin because I watched him play for the Mooseheads. But as much as I can say right now, they lost that trade big time, guys. They need a defenseman. They've got these little guys like Plekanec, like Gallagher, like Byron to just skate around up the ice. They need a defenseman. They need someone to count on back there. Jay Weber's going to be in a retirement home in 3 years. He's out every third game with a knee injury. So anyway, that's my little rant. Back to you, Ian.
Yeah, it's warranted. I mean, this team has been fucked from here to kingdom come by Marc Bergevin, as far as I'm concerned. Done a terrible job, no question about that. You look at, you talk about the All-Stars. Where's the All-Stars on this team? You talk about Jonathan Drouin and his one assist in the last 8 games. You're talking about your captain, Max Pacioretty, with his 11-game goalless drought. I mean, those are your options right now. Those are supposed to be the leaders taking you to the to good and promising things for this Montreal team. Look what they're doing. And here's Claude Julien now shaking things up. Now another top line shuffle. You know, Drouin and Pacioretty now are going to be split up. He's going to see if that gets the offense going. It's the same old shit. He just tries to juggle the lines over and over again. And, you know, oftentimes it doesn't do a damn thing to help it. You know, it's like the hokey pokey. You put your max patch in, you take your max patch out, you put your max patch in, you shuffle the lines all about, you shuffle all the lines, and it probably won't work out. That's what the Habs are all about. You know, the shuffle all these lines over and over again. Claude
Julien. Games on the schedule, guys. 5 games on the schedule.
That's right. So that's why you get treated to Ian Karaoke today. Yeah, exactly why. Yeah, got some time to burn. But Andrew ran about this Habs team, which continues to go south, which is always a lot of fun. Maybe not for Andrew, but for Dana and I, it's a lot of fun. So Montreal up against it probably again tonight. Dana on the Florida side. And Andrew providing us with a terrific rant, by the way. He's got every right to be upset with this hockey team right now. Been a massive disappointment and not doing things the right way anywhere. Management's not doing well. Coaching's not good enough right now. And your top players are nowhere to be seen. As I like to say, and I say it often, can't find your Montreal top players with a telescope on the ice right now. And that's a big, big problem for them.
Hey guys, thanks for tuning in to our channel. Now we've put a lot of work into producing all these free videos, so please help us out and keep all our content free for you forever by simply liking, sharing, commenting, and subscribing. Now, not to mention, a visit to our industry-leading website will warm the hearts of all our SBR employees, especially myself. Now, the links are over there to the left, so do check those out. Thanks for watching.